Hello and a very happy Back to Hogwarts Day. We're here at Leavesden Studio, the home of Warner Brothers Studio Tour London, The Making of Harry Potter. And for 10 years, the cast and crew of the Harry Potter films called Leavesden home. When they wrapped on the Deathly Hallows Part 2, the studio was left with some astonishing artifacts that wouldn't normally be saved after filming. And now, 20 years after the release of the first movie, you can get behind the scenes of the magic and see some of the iconic sets, and none of them are more unique than the Hogwarts Express. And we are very lucky today to have two families of Harry Potter superfans with us who have never seen the Hogwarts Express before.
Oh, this is actually really cool.
Whoa.
There it is, guys, that famous train.
So exciting.
Being here in front of the iconic Hogwarts Express, how does it feel?
It just reminds me of my childhood.
And it's obviously 20 years since the release of the first film. Do you remember when you saw it?
I went to the cinema with my friend and it became like a thing. We watched every Harry Potter movie together.
Well, very exciting to be here, of course. And we're very lucky to have one of the interactors here from the Warner Brothers Studio Tour London. She is an expert on all things Harry Potter. Hi, Rianne.
Hi everyone, welcome. We are on the platform 9 3/4 set. We are standing right next to the original Hogwarts Express train used in the films. It was an actual working train. It was called the Alton Hall. Once we painted it red for the films, we began filming in a train station in London. Can you guess which one?
King's Cross.
It was King's Cross, you are right. Obviously big Harry Potter fans there. One character that had a little issue when she got to King's Cross was Julie Walters, who played Mrs. Weasley. They'd padded out her costume using birdseed. She was chased by pigeons all the way from the top end of the platform right to the bottom. If you have a look at the train, you'll see it looks really, really narrow, that aisle going down the centre. You can't get a camera crew in there. When they filmed inside the train, they used a set just like that one over there.
This is the Rune Star.
This is so comfy.
How did you build the set?
We had to build a track to slide the train into position in the studios, then build the entire set and the soundstage around it.
It's a lot of work.
It is a lot of work. It was a whole mission.
Is that the green screen?
Yeah, you're right. That is the green screen. Many things would have come up on the green screen, including the Dementors. The actors would have had to pretend that it's really cold in the carriage because that is what they would have seen out of the window.
This is so fun.
It is fun.
You guys are obviously Harry Potter super fans. How much are you looking forward to passing it on to the kids when they're old enough?
It's a classic, isn't it? How can you not want to pass it down? Definitely looking forward to like Christmases, sat around watching, you know, watching all the movies.
There is one thing I would like you all to help me with before we go. Should we officially send this steam train off to Hogsmeade? Okay, so I'm gonna count you down, and on three, we are gonna say all aboard. Are you ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
All aboard!
Thank you very much, guys. That was absolutely fantastic. And from all of us here at the Platform 9 3/4 set at Warner Brothers Studio Tour London, wishing you a very, very happy Back to Hogwarts Day. See you soon.